December 2017 Foreign Service Journal. President's Views. By AFSA President Ambassador Barbara Stephenson. I begin with a reminder that we, the members of the Career Foreign Service, have an obligation as stewards of our institution to be effective advocates for why diplomacy matters. That requires some skill in explaining how diplomacy works. While raising awareness of and appreciation for the Foreign Service is a long-standing goal, one AFSA has pursued with renewed vigor and impact over the past couple years, the need to make the case for the Foreign Service with fellow Americans and our elected representatives has taken on a new urgency. The cover of the Time magazine that arrived as I was writing this column jarred me with its graphic of wrecking balls and warning of dismantling government as we know it. While I do my best, as principal advocate for our institution, and as a seasoned American diplomat, to model responsible civil discourse, there is simply no denying the warning signs that point to mounting threats to our institution and to the global leadership that depends on us. There is no denying that our leadership ranks are being depleted at a dizzying speed, due in part to the decision to slash promotion numbers by more than half. The Foreign Service Officer Corps at State has lost 60% of its career ambassadors since January. Ranks of career ministers, our three-star equivalents, are down from 33 to 19. The ranks of our two-star minister counselors have fallen from 431 right after Labor Day to 369 today, and are still falling. These numbers are hard to square with the stated agenda of making state and the Foreign Service stronger. Were the U.S. military to face such a decapitation of its leadership ranks, I would expect a public outcry. Like the military, the Foreign Service recruits officers at entry level and grows them into seasoned leaders over decades. The talent being shown the door now is not only our top talent, but also talent that cannot be replicated overnight. The rapid loss of so many senior officers has a serious, immediate, and tangible effect on the capacity of the United States to shape world events. Meanwhile, the self-imposed hiring freeze is taking its toll at the entry level. Intake into the Foreign Service at State will drop from 366 in 2016 to around 100 new entry-level officers joining A100 in 2018, including 60 Pickering and Wrangell Fellows. Not surprisingly, given the blocked entry path, interest in joining the Foreign Service is plummeting. I wrote with pride in my March 2016 column that more than 17,000 people applied to take the Foreign Service officer test last year, citing interest in joining the Foreign Service as a key indicator of the health of the institution. What does it tell us, then, that we are on track to have fewer than half as many people take the Foreign Service officer test this year? As the shape and extent of the staffing cuts to the Foreign Service at State become clearer, I believe we must shine a light on these disturbing trends and ask why, and to what end,